Well, 93 days after becoming Prime Minister, Julia Gillard has finally moved into the lodge. There was no official handover from Kevin Rudd, just a welcome from the butler.
A spring clean, and the lodge was ready for its latest tenant. After taking the keys via a leadership coup and with a tentative minority government, Julia Gillard appeared uneager with the move, her partner Tim a little more at ease. With a 40-room mansion, Australia's first couple has plenty of living space and 4.4 acres to enjoy.
Just having a wander in the gardens on a beautiful Canberra day.
But Ms Gillard believes one man wants to make her stay extremely brief. She's accused the opposition leader of reneging on a deal to pair votes for the Speaker and his deputy, which would protect the government's slim majority.
He's acting like a bull in a china shop, thinking his job is to smash everything he sees up.
There seems to be some confusion in the Labor Party that apparently being more cooperative means that they have to get their own way all the time.
The Prime Minister will have many tough issues to ponder during her time here at the Lodge, and possibly none more so than euthanasia. Parliament will soon hold a conscience vote on the controversial topic, and a weekend poll has found that there's overwhelming public support to make euthanasia legal.
The vote will be introduced by the Greens' Bob Brown, but the PM says she hasn't yet made up her mind.
If we did say that euthanasia was legal, I find it almost impossible to conceptualise how there could be appropriate steps and safeguards. So I'm, you know, conflicted on it in that sense.
A cop-out with no legal precedent, says euthanasia campaigner Dr. Philip Nitschke. James Boyce, 10 News.